Welcome back all. Coming towards the end of the day, we would now have a demonstration on Micromedics. IBM Micromedics Solutions have been a leading global medical resource for the last 50 years. Micromedics is a pioneer in evidence-based drug and disease insights, toxicology information, and patient-friendly education materials, and more, all at the point of care. To put more light on this topic, I would like to call Professor Sunita Pawar Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Clinical Pharmacy, Pune College of Pharmacy, Bharati Vidyapeeth University. She has completed her post-graduation from Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Science, Bangalore, and is currently pursuing her PhD from Bharati Vidyapeeth University, Pune. She has about 10 years of academic experience and over 6 years of clinical research experience. She has carried out various clinical trials and has been pharmacologist for National Pharmacovigilance Program at Eastern Regional Center, Kolkata. She has organized and conducted over 10 workshops and seminars and has participated in more than 10 international as well as national conferences. She has published and presented more than 20 research papers nationally and internationally. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Jilu. I'm very happy to take you through the brief of today's speaker, Ms. Millie Taos. She is going to take a very important session and a demo on a very eminent database, that is Micromedics. And this Micromedics database definitely is very unique in itself, wherein many people may be aware of it already, especially who are practicing and using it in the clinical setup. And some of you are definitely would be going through it, but maybe something new. So let us understand today and participate fully and get and a very eminent knowledge about this very unique database that is Micromedics. So let me run you through the introduction of Ms. Millie Taos. She has got a very eminent experience of about 15 years in the business leadership and training, and has played very eminent and significant roles in the healthcare technology. She is a qualified physiotherapist with a specialization in neuropediatrics and certified professional from Childbirth and Postpartum Professional Association, and has been a part of many strategic healthcare-related IT initiatives. In her current role at Dicno, she spearheads the IBM Micromedics business. With her team, she is helping healthcare providers offer consistency in the quality of the care and improvement in patient outcomes. So with a little background of Micromedics database, let us hand over the session to ma'am. So Micromedics IBM Solutions have been a leading global medical resource for the last 50 years. Micromedics is a pioneer in evidence-based drug and disease insights, toxicology information, and patient-friendly education materials, and more of all the patient care points at one place. So let us get into the talk by Millie Taos. Madam Millie Taos, may I invite you to please proceed with your talk? Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Pawar, for the introduction. And definitely I would start with a session, and we would definitely cover a few new insights what are have actually started with Micromedics recently. They have introduced few new features for keeping clinicians and pharmacists in mind. So not wasting further any time, I'll just share my screen. I'm going to present a PPT. Just please let me know if you are able to see once I share. Is it visible
right? Yes, now? Ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So first of all, thank you so much for inviting us on this platform here to talk about Micromedics. And I'm pretty sure that a lot of you who are already in this conference, they have used Micromedics for a long time and maybe are already aware about Micromedics. And probably you guys are the best users who can give us feedback whenever something you find the searching capability, how useful it is and all that. Definitely you guys are more expert, but I'll just give a few insights from my end. Basically, nowadays, Micromedics is part of IBM Watson, and that's the whole reason why the entire technology or the new era thing, like AI integration, which is called as artificial intelligence, has been integrated to Micromedics. This is the first ever database where AI has been integrated for the search. So it makes more feasible cognitive kind of a search for all the pharmacists and clinicians at the point of care when they want to. They are during some ER sessions or on some rounds when they need this critical information. So at that point of time, they can actually state in a lot of questions and queries exactly the way they are striking conversation with their colleagues or clinicians. It's like so intelligent to pick up your words. Basically, Micromedics is a platform where we have more than 25 to 30 databases related to all clinical information. So it mainly addresses medication safety and patient education and care and interaction checks. So these few databases or the combination of few databases which we have seen is really important set of databases for hospitals, for clinical pharmacists, and a few more institutes where they find most of the databases is like the set of whole wholesome information. They don't have to go anywhere else when they are trying to search something in Micromedics. So that's why we even call it as a clinical decision support tool. So it's like when you're searching about a drug, you can navigate your search through disease also. From there, you can navigate to drug interactions as well. From there also, you can directly navigate your search to the toxicity part or any poison information part or any kind of a patient education part. So that's why it's like a wholesome 360 degree platform, what we call it as. So this is like a recent studies, and this is like a global study, not only related to one region of world, where we have found that third leading cause of death is medical errors, which is actually not being spoken very frankly in India or even outside India. So this data is when the medical errors are happening, so this is only our responsibility in this healthcare sector where we can use certain evidence-based resources through which you can actually provide authentic information and with confidence to any of the clinicians or any of the practitioners who's relying on you for that information. That's why this kind of resources are useful. Also, we have found that if a clinician or a pharmacist has to be updated or wants to keep himself updated on any recent information, they might need like 29 hours to update themselves. This is just a general study what we have come across. So that is not possible because we understand quite a busy people, and they sometimes don't even get time to like sit in a day calmly and quietly. So going through certain recent studies and materials becomes little impossible. So this is what we are trying to incorporate in the workflow itself, that in whole day when they are trying to search something, the information and which is recently very authentically updated in a database is at just one click away from them. So where Micromedics actually comes in role to provide, as I told you, evidence-based information at any time and anywhere. So maybe if you are in working with the doctors in ER department or going on rounds for ICUs or any department where you are going, so there you can find this information at just one click. Even we have included now standardized patient care protocols, all the guidelines are there. So even these new things are included in microfluidics. So when you want to search some information on drugs, and definitely DrugDex is our flagship product. We take really pride about telling everyone that, yeah, on drug information, we are the best in market and we have the most updated information. So whenever there is a question on an interaction or a drug, on maybe any of the queries, like a simple question like pharmacokinetics or the ADMA of that drug or any kind of a query. So any clinician or any pharmacist or nurses, they can go to Micromedex, they refer this thing as a source of information, and with very much of confidence, they can give out this information. They don't have to search like 10 different sources and then come out with this decision of sharing information on maybe on drugs or treatment, any sort of thing. So basically, Micromedex is almost like 50 years old now, and there are like more than 80 countries and 4,500 hospitals, government organization, pharmacy colleges, and pharma companies. All of them are using Micromedex with they are actually quite a happy customers, and they are very happy to have this authentic and heterogeneous source of information with them, because our content has that kind of in-depth information from mostly more than 8,500 journals and more than 550,000 publishers. Basically, all this information, the way it is collected, we have a editorial board where actually our team of clinician, nurses, and pharmacists, they go out and collect the information, any press releases, toxicology information, or any critical information which is released. So this information is collected and peer reviewed, and not sort of repetitive, or any information which is being authenticated is only included in Micromedex with a very systematic format. And this entire process is actually accredited through NICE. So there is a level of confidence for the content quality, you can say, because it is the highest level of accreditation. That is from UK. And yeah, so most probably why we came out with this idea of AI integration with the workflow. AI integration is called as Ask Watson. So basically, we thought pharmacists are the ones who are actually using this information, and they need this kind of information day to day. That is like they are involved more in this fraternity for circulating authentic information. That's why. And for making their lives easy, we came out with this idea of having a cognitive search tool into Micromedex. So that was the whole idea behind having AI integration with Micromedex. So basically, this is the way if you have used Micromedex. There are multiple sources how you can use Micromedex. One is like login ID password access is there. One is you can integrate with your system. And one is like IP authenticated thing, where you can just click on the logo and you can log in from your campus itself. So this, when you log in from username and ID password, something like this will come up your screen, and you can just click on Micromedex tab, and it will take you to the home page, which exactly is a really important or the core of this database, where you can see on this part, where I have put this arrow, you can actually build in your search related to drug, disease, maybe related to some interaction or some sort of toxicology information about poison. You can just directly build your search here. And I would also like to spend a little bit of time telling you about all these new features and all boxes, what you can see here. It is really different from what Micromedex used to look earlier. So latest news is definitely I would encourage whosoever is having this subscription, please go to this section and go and see about the latest news events or whatever is happening in the world. They are updating this information here in the news section, as well as in the support and training part. If you are part of Micromedics family and you have subscription, so you get actually access to trainings and the content library on demand. Definitely you get even simulations and live seminars and everything. You can request for it and you can go and update your knowledge there. So that is all time available. So content is at one click. It is available there. In the resource section, as you can see, this section was built specially when we found out that a lot of pharmacists and poison information and drug information centers try to search information when they get a call or a query, which is very urgent. So this was the section created because of that. So here you don't have to build a query or search going into a tab. You can directly click on these tabs and directly go on the section which you are interested to find information. So it will provide you a very easy access to a very critical sort of information in this database. On the right side, as you can see, there is a section, a search tab. It is called as Ask Watson. This is the tool I was emphasizing a lot on. This is our AI tool. So here you can actually type in a conversational question. When I see a conversational question is, for example, maybe I want to see what are the drugs that can cause hypertension. So maybe I can build my direct question here and I'll get answers. Earlier it is, we used to see information like this. I have kept this slide deliberately to show you the difference. What is the difference and what is the use of AI tool? As you can see, drug name is there, indication is given, as well as the age group. So you can just directly go and click on adult or pediatric, whosoever you are interested to check the information for. So now you would see, once you type in question here, as I told you in AI tool, so here these are like direct questions. It is giving you an answer, which is like filtering out answers for you. And this is actually the solution for your query, what you might have built searching in AI. And this is the relevant link where actually you can click and go to that section directly. So you are not searching entire monograph of 200 pages to find one piece of information at point of care. That is the benefit. And I would suggest when you're using AI tool, it prompts you to give a feedback. So if you give a thumbs up or thumbs down, it will automatically intelligently process that the search what you conducted was correct, the information or the quality of search was okay. So this will be really helpful when you are conducting your next search. So your tool becomes more intelligent when you try and interact more with that tool. It can be customized. It is very conversational and interactive. So this is a very general monograph, which is like our flagship product, as I told you, DrugDex. This drug has been, I have just taken one example from DrugDex, where you can actually find on left side all the hyperlinks related to dosing, administration, medication safety part is there, or mechanism of action, pharmacokinetics, patient education, toxicology. And most important is references. Here, each and every document is supported with reference. So anytime, any point of time you're using this information or you want to quote it somewhere, you can actually do it with confidence. You can cite Micromedics with references with full confidence. There is also a really important section which I definitely always love to display when I'm giving presentation, is comparative efficacy part. So this is according to our experience when we go to hospitals and do trainings, a lot of doctors and clinicians, they come across and tell us this is a very good tool which is useful. And why it is useful? Because they can actually compare the efficacy of different drugs at same point of time. And it's really useful when it comes to taking socioeconomic decisions. If a patient is not able to afford a certain kind of a drug, then maybe you can just quickly go and see and pick up an alternative for that. And you exactly know what will be the side effects, what will be the complete ADMA of that drug, and what all information you need to know before you prescribe that drug to some patient. Another thing I would like to point out here is there is a section here which is showing drug interaction as single. So this is a hyperlink. Whenever you click this link, it will take you automatically, for example, whichever is my search term, like for example, atorvastatin. So it will pick up by default atorvastatin and it will start comparing, or it will start interactions, show me the interactions, all possible interactions with atorvastatin. It will pick up randomly all the drugs, which is, it is saying, okay, fine, according to your search, these are the drugs are interacting, or there is a possible interaction with your built-in query. So this is how the monograph would look like. So here, drug interaction is a totally different database altogether. So here we have like almost 13 levels of interactions, which for a few examples, it's like drug, 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 food, alcohol, lactation, pregnancy, drug duplication, and even more. The most important part here for a clinician's or a pharmacist's point of view is, once you click on this link, wherever you can, you are finding this interactions, it will give you a entire detailed literature why it is talking about this thing. As you can see, it is showing the severity in color demarcations, like contraindications or major or minor, that sort of thing. So it will explain you what exactly is the onset, what is the severity, what exactly is the clinical management part of it. Okay, fine, we are telling this has a major interaction. But what can be the next step then? In that case, what is the clinical management of it? And entire thing is supported through a very short kind of a summary of a literature why we are talking about this interaction in a certain way. Here we also give you the level of documentation we have. So you actually have a fair idea that are we talking about the level of documentation which is done on this drug? Is it excellent? Is it fair? Or is it like, what is the level of grading system we have done? Why we are talking about certain drug in a way. It also gives you a short summary label information where you can actually see what all things they are suggesting. A lot of interactions, they usually happen with food products or alternative medicines. Especially in India, we have come across that lot of people, they have this habit of having allopathic medicines, plus they will start doing some home remedy or maybe Ayurveda, because we consider that there is no side effect of Ayurveda or homeopathic. But definitely there are certain interactions which do happen, and that's why patient face a lot of problems. So one different thing, you would say, okay, fine, you gave me a preset kind of a interaction tool. But what if I have a patient who has almost like 20 drugs in his list, and I want to check possible interactions happening in his drugs, because he, for example, he has a multiple condition, like cardiac condition, or maybe he's also diabetic along with that, and he's also on some neuro kind of a drugs. So there you can go to this section, which is called as View Multiple Drug Interactions. Once you click on this, you will actually go to this section, where you can actually type in your choice of drugs. You can put almost more than 26 drugs at a same one point of time here. And you can, if you are confident enough that your patient is allergic to certain things, you can even add allergies from here. So it will also indicate you about the allergies, if there is some possible interaction or patient is allergic to some content in the drug. It will definitely display that thing even in your monograph. So once you put in all the drugs, add allergies, you just submit your request, and you will again find the same sort of tabular thing in front of you with color demarcation. So it will become you very customized kind of a search for your patient. So this tool is really useful when it comes to DICs and PICs, when they receive calls from hospitals or maybe some emergency call or internal queries from doctors. And so that's where we consider that pharmacist has a really, really important role in this entire cycle, because they are the only one who can provide authentic information even to doctors. There is one, again, a really good tool we have is IV compatibility, where not only tablets and capsules, you can actually even compare IV drugs here. So it will also show you the compatibility if you can mix those or make a mixture and give it from the Y side, or what should be the stability of the solution when you are mixing certain things, and how should be the storage, what exactly will be the effect of that drug once you are mixing that, for how many hours it can be used. So these kind of critical information, it is not possible for everyone to remember. So once you put in your query here, you will find, as I told you, color demarcations are there. So it will clearly state, is this drug compatible, what I'm trying to administrate? And if it is not, then what exactly, on from what site I can do that, for how many hours that solution can remain stable, how am I going to store that, or what is the kind of infiltration required to prepare this drug? So these kind of a very small, small critical information, you can actually go and measure here, you can see here, and then you can do it with confidence. And this entire information for IV compatibility is taken from TRISIL's clinical tools pharmaceutical database. I'm sure most of you must be aware about the TRISIL's handbook, which used to be there. And now it is like converted. Everything is like now online. So this information is coming from there. So it is that authentic. You can actually use it with confidence. There is one more really good tool, which is drug comparison. This is also part of DrugDex. Here you can actually populate almost 5 to 6 drugs at same point of time, but you can definitely compare only 2 drugs side by side. And here it is a drop-down option. So I just want to compare telmisartan with some other drug in my list. So I can change this drug and I get this side-by-side kind of a comparison table in front of me. So it becomes really easy for me to actually go through this drug, compare it and analyze, okay, fine, which is the right kind of a drug for my patient right now. So there are almost 12 criteria where you can actually compare side-by-side. And you will get very critical information like adverse effects, black box warning, and all this information side by side. You just don't have to open like 2 monographs differently. Then you will go and search in one window and then open another window. So it's not like that. That's why we call it as a very seamless kind of a workflow, which you can navigate internally. Other than that, a really important database, which I'm pretty sure all of you must be using is PoisonDex. That gives you information on hundreds and thousands of drugs, including chemicals, industrial chemicals, household products. So any kind of queries, if you are getting related to poison here, you can actually type in that and you can search. The most important thing is if you are using it in ER, it will give you a life support tab where you can actually click on it and it will tell you the immediate treatment in emergency, what you have to do in that case. Or maybe in your case, you can just suggest that, okay, fine, this will be the right approach, this drugs to be given, what should be the antidote if you are confident about what kind of poison intake is there, and so on and so forth. So it will also tell you about the entire kinetics, what is the maximum lethal exposure for that specific poison or drug toxicity, or what will be the effect of this toxicity on different parts of your patients, like maybe related to heart, or maybe related to brain, or maybe something related to maybe on his gastrointestinal system. So there are different therapeutic areas which they have described in a very detailed format once you want to go and do an in-depth search. So it is useful in both the scenarios, even case of emergency and even at the point where you want to conduct some research and actually come to a conclusion that why this is happening, what I can do to make it better further, so on and so forth. And this all databases which I'm right now displaying in front of you, these are, they all come with references. So wherever it is some article abstract is available, it will be given there. You can actually go and even read those articles. If it is a free source, it will be available. If you have a subscription, you can directly navigate your search through that link would be provided, and you can access that entire information from there. There is another database that is DiseaseDex, and which is really dynamically changing right now in Micromedics, because we have a really amazing tie-up with DynaMed right now. So they have a very minute kind of, they are like pioneers on the disease information in market. So if you talk about any sort of chronic or acute illness or some sort of emergency protocols required for a condition, for example, a patient is coming in an ER with a chest pain, and you don't know exactly what is wrong with him, what is happening. So looking at his symptoms, you can directly built in your query, you can actually type in questions that my patient is having chest pain, what can be the causes, or what drugs can cause chest pain, or what are the possible first line of treatment I can use in this case. So here, that's why it is really important. These are two different databases which tells you about acute and chronic treatment part of disease. So it will also give you detailed information about what all tests to be conducted, what all emergency drugs to be given, how you can compare a few things and come to a conclusion about differential diagnosis here. And here you also get drug consults and disease abstracts, what our expert has gone through and written in their own language, giving a conclusion about certain drug or a disease to give you that level of confidence that how this clinical trial was conducted and how this drug reacted in this disease, how this drug was working. So that hyperlink is also provided. You can go and you can search that thing. So there is one more important section called as clinical checklist. So once you click on a clinical checklist, you will exactly know always do and never do. So this is a really important section, because here we tell you about diagnosis, the management goals or treatment part of it, what all tests to be done immediately, and we actually give you strength of recommendation and evidence on that. We have done this grading system according to colors and alphabets. So if you click on these are also hyperlinks. If you click on that, it will give you a detailed description that what is the level of strength, why we are saying and how we are describing this thing. Other than that, what I have found in my trainings that nowadays patient education is the most important part when it comes to maybe medical counseling or giving out patient handouts whenever it is coming, because this entire responsibility comes on clinical pharmacists, that ultimately the prescription is written, the disease has been diagnosed, everything has been done. But when the drug is dispensed at that point of time, the important role is for clinical pharmacists to explain patient, because that is the only interaction where patient is sitting very calmly and quietly in front of a clinically qualified person who he can ask his questions, because doctors, they will always write the prescriptions and they will give it to them, and they don't have that much time to sit and explain them how this drug has to be administered or how you have to take this drug. So these small things actually makes a lot of difference in patient outcome. So I'm sure here a lot of people will agree, because we have seen this example in last 15 years. I have been seeing, because a lot of people, they complained that hum logon ne drug diya tha, but we couldn't explain him how to take it, and the patient comes back after like 8 or 10 days and says, okay, fine, this was supposed to be taken orally, but we couldn't tell her and she was just applying it topically. So there are a lot of chances that it might happen if your patient is not that educated. So that becomes a responsibility, and nowadays it is kind of a compulsion, I would say, if I'm stating it right, that clinical pharmacists, they have to counsel patient on critical drugs or some side effects or how that drug has to be taken. So this is the section where actually if you are working in a hospital scenario, then you can actually find this document from care notes where if a patient has gone through some surgery or some procedure and he's being discharged, at that point of time, you can take a printout of this document and give it to him, explaining his entire condition. Because you don't want your patient to go and Google everything and come to you, okay, sir, maine ye dekha tha, this is the information I found. So it's better to give them evidence-based information from your end. So this, what is the benefit of care notes or patient education databases? It talks in a very simple language. So it is not made for clinicians. It is made for patients. So it will talk in a very fifth or sixth grade of English language, where actually it will state what was wrong with your, for example, what was wrong with your heart? What was the procedure done? If you would wish to share that information with them, rather than they going and Googling that thing and coming back to you with some different sort of complications. That's why this right kind of information is important to be given. So I have deliberately put a snapshot for this, because if you just want to give, for example, any kind of a drug, here the medication counseling instructions are already given. And a very simple language where you can actually read out these things and you can explain your patient in the way you want them. And the kind of information, the amount of information you want to give them, that is more important, because too much of information is also really bad. I'm sure you guys will agree. So this is a really important section for clinical pharmacists, what you find in micromedics. Another most important thing is calculators. And this is like the most underrated database from micromedics, because we have not been talking about this thing, but it actually carries a lot of vital information. There are almost 24 preset calculators here you can find. Mostly these are really useful when it comes to poison information centers, because you find antidote dosing information here. You just click on whichever calculator you find it right. You have to put in the parameters, whatever it gives, and if you click submit, it will calculate the dosage in the right fashion according to the patient's parameters, not according to the criteria what book is telling you or what you have maybe studied in past. But for example, your patient is pediatric, or your patient is some geriatric population belongs to that, and according to his height, weight, and his symptoms, you can actually calculate exactly what amount of dose can be administered at that point of time. Here, there are a few critical, and you will also find lab values. Here, you can actually go and search and calculate whatever is information required. Here, you will find it will also give you a critical information about on what should be the solution or the dilution concentration you should take, or for how much time this thing should be given, administered, or what will be the possible speed on what you have to administrate this drug. So this kind of critical information, you will actually find it from here. And I can assure you, there are a lot of drugs which can even cause toxicity if given in a little more concentration. So there, the critically, I have seen a lot of nurses and pharmacists, they used to start calculating with hands. Like, okay, fine, we will calculate this thing according to your patient needs. So this is, there is no chance of error, because the slightest chance of even human error can cost a lot when it comes to healthcare. So here you can actually use everything with confidence and you will get it in like 2 seconds time. Even your time is valuable when it comes to calculating and doing this critical sort of thing. So definitely micromedics can be trusted, because, and we have so many customers from all these years because of we have a really good source of information, multiple sources of information, as well as it is evidence-based. It is not just, it is published somewhere and we have picked it up and we are trying to give out that information. It is not like that. And nowadays, information in micromedics is updated on almost daily basis. So not each and every document would be updated, but definitely there is a section where you can go and find what all drugs are updated, what updates are given there. So there you can actually pull out entire list of drugs where the updation has been done. Or other than that, if you are searching some drug, if their numbers are given, hyperlinks, you click on that and you can go in the last section and you can find when this information was last updated. So you know what kind of recent information you are using or how old information you are using, like that. And as I told you, our entire data is peer reviewed, and actually it's a very comprehensive, unbiased information. We definitely don't trust or rely on some information coming from just A resource or B resource. It's like a global kind of heterogeneous sources we take information. And every document is supported with references, as I already told you, mentioned. And this entire process is accredited through NICE, which is from UK. So that is a level of confidence. You can trust the quality and the content of Micromedics. So thanks a lot. And I hope this information was useful for you. And if in future you think that you want to use AI tool, or maybe you have some queries related to that, because that is the most recent updation what we have. So you can please write to us or call us or anything we can help you with.
Hello. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. I must say that ma'am has taken us very well through a very thorough detailed information about this beautiful database that is Micromedics. She has given us a very nice and a deep insight about how to use this database, all the interfaces and datas which are, you know, integrated in this particular Micromedics, plus the new additions which have occurred or happened in the form of standard treatment guidelines, and how the information is available handy and quick and easily everywhere with the workflow at one click. Also the AE integrated workflow nature of it, and various new sections, plus a very interesting tool that is Ask Watson, which is conversational and interactive tool and gives all the possible answers query to it. Apart from this, the beauty of this particular Micromedics is that by now we know that after her talk, that all authentic, updated, evidence-based information of now medicines and its profile at one place, which is so easy and handy, and it is so well referenced and standardized that at one click, whatever information we get at one hand, we can, it is very reliable and we can believe it at one go and provide it to anyone, be it doctor or go for academic use, for patient care, or anything related to medicines. So at the end of this, I would say that, like, we all got a very nice and a very thorough information about this beautiful database that is Micromedics. The only thing that how well we use it, how well we practice it, it is going to be, you know, very, very friendly to us and will be benefiting all of us and also to whomever we would like to, you know, make use of it. So thank you. Thank you to ma'am very much. And at the end, to all the delegates as well, who have been patiently listening and has acquired a good knowledge today due to this particular demonstration. Thank you. Thank you, Millie ma'am, once again. Anybody, I would invite all the delegates for asking any queries or questions. We have a very beautiful chance wherein such a learned person is there with us, who's practically actually using it and has been into it. So can you please, all of you, be interactive by asking some few queries and questions at your end. Hello, all the delegates. Millie ma'am, are you there? Hello, Millie ma'am. Hello. Can you, she's muted actually. Unmute her. Hello.
Yeah, actually I was not able to unmute.
Okay. Now, we did that from our end, ma'am. I must thank you personally once again. Ma'am, I had a query. Like we have been also using, because all our family students have been using here, and the staff has been guiding them for that. And actually, the practice spaces every day, daily basis, when they go for ward rounds and they get the queries, they are actually making use of this only. But only one thing, ma'am, the way you said the standard treatment guidelines have been added newly over here. Are these treatment guidelines and all, are they global guidelines or any country specific, even customized guidelines are also there which can use, because it may differ prevalence wise. So just wanted to know.
The thing is, whenever it comes to anything related to drug or disease or treatment part, the entire information would be global, not related to a specific country or a continent. Yeah. So that's the whole intention. That's why we say it's like unbiased kind of information given out. But yeah, there are. If you would wish to see a very minute kind of a thing that, okay, I want to see some sort of studies done on this specific thing. So there is a section called as drug consults, as I told you. So there you can actually find clinical trials, the summary part of it, the entire literature is given there. So there you will find whole information if you wish to. But yeah, to answer your question correctly, the source would be global, not related to a specific country.
Okay. And one last this thing, additional question to the same, this continuation, that when we talk about the patient counseling and the patient information, as you said, so that part, patient-specific counselings, if you take the Western scenario and the usage over there, the distinct are customs and traditions are different as compared to what our, say for example, Indian scenario is there. So from that point of view also, I just wanted to know, again, as you've already answered, I think that it's a global information. So that can be a limitation, I think.
I'm so sorry. If you are finished, then maybe I can. So your question is absolutely correct here, because to the point, when we talk about having guidelines or maybe something specific related to counseling, so it has to be customized, because it cannot work one thing for every patient, right? So as you rightly said, there are two sections. If you remember, I explained that there is a section of medication safety where it gives you handouts and medication counseling advice. Plus, there is a section of care notes. So care notes, there we have an admin access tool where you can actually go and edit the document according to your need and customize it for your patient. If you feel that US, if on something related to US guidelines or some brands which we don't use here, you just want to remove it, you can actually delete that information and you can put information which you find relevant for your region.
Okay, ma'am. Fine, ma'am. Ma'am, that's all. Amongst the delegates, if anybody would like to, otherwise we can end today's session.
I would just end up with, I just missed out on one thing, that is we also have a Micromedics mobile app. So please go and download it and use it, because whenever the internet availability is not there in any part of your hospital or college, from there you can actually use this Micromedics app, which is offline.
Okay, ma'am. I think students are already using it.
Okay,
and,
great.
There was one question from the delegates.
Whether
the clinical pharmacist should be involved in medical teaching or counseling, which one is appropriate?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I couldn't hear if you are asking any question.
Hello, ma'am. Can you hear me?
Yeah, it's better now.
Yeah. So, ma'am, there is a question from a delegate stating that whether clinical pharmacists should be involved in bedside teaching or counseling, which one is appropriate?
The thing is, according to our experience, we have seen that nowadays clinical pharmacists, it is compulsory to involve them.
Okay.
Because whenever it comes to even because we are working with few of government bodies like Maharashtra State Pharmacy Council and Karnataka State Pharmacy Council. So these councils are educating all pharmacists, and there is a reason for conducting this courses through Micromedics, because they are using this information, training them, because they are capable enough to talk to patient and counsel them.
Yes.
So I guess it will also depend on the hospital's policy. If they are wanting to interact their pharmacists, at what point of time?
Exactly.
But yeah, I mean, I am very much aware about this thing because we very closely work with these councils, and they are educating pharmacists for this main reason.
Yeah, yes, ma'am. The same experience which I would like to also share that in our hospital as well. Not all counselings can be conducted by clinical pharmacists only. There are specific counselors, say, for example, for the HIV patients, for typical otic patients, for pediatrics or for gynec. So their restrictions are there, but under their supervision and with them, along with them, the clinical pharmacist can sit and observe how they are counseling. So this is also there, and other parts like they are allowed to counsel. So there is also one more query, ma'am. Can I put it? So one of the delegates would like to know, are clinical pharmacists trained to carry out clinical teaching?
Clinical teachings, according to what we have been conducting trainings, so we never come across directly training clinical pharmacists, because there is a program what is called as Train the Trainer. So any clinical pharmacist who's like wholesome, who's experienced and who has been conducting the sources, but it has to be done through some government body, what I understand.
Okay. Okay.
But directly a pharmacist cannot go and start training any other pharmacist till the time you are approved to do that directly.
Okay.
But yeah, for CMEs and continuous education and everything, we do provide certificates when you complete courses from Micromedics. So you are certified. It says that you are in your way full with knowledge on this topic. That doesn't definitely states that you can go and conduct a training outside somewhere.
Hope this has answered the query. Thank you so much, ma'am, once again.
Thank you so much, ma'am. That was keenly explained, and thank you for accepting our invitation. With this, we have come to the end of day two. That was a huge response to our program, and I hope many have fed their brains with a quite informative and useful sessions. Now, I request everyone to kindly turn on their cameras for a photo session.
Actually, I'm trying, but I don't know, somehow it shows that it has started video. Can you see? Just a minute. I'll try again. Yeah. Now I guess it's visible. Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. Let's meet tomorrow for another amazing lectures. And till then, thank you and goodbye.
Thanks a lot, everyone. Bye-bye.